Hello, my dear students. Today I have prepared notes of deep water question answers which will help you all in the examination, okay? Which is written by William Douglas. So, without wasting time, let us start. Question number one. What is the theme of this story? Here you have to mention 4 points. First one is fear is the obstacle to success and happiness. Negative feelings comes in our mind because of fear and it makes us passive and it handicaps us. Okay. Persistent efforts can help us get rid of this fear and our hope and determination as well. Power and optimism. Power of optimism is unlimited. If we have power of optimism, that is positive thinking, then we can overcome any fear, any obstacle of our life. Okay. Question number two. Why was Douglas determined to get over his fear of water? First point should be, it leaves indelible mark on the writer. Phobia of water hampered all his joys of water sports, like canoeing, boating, swimming, etc. He did not want to handicap himself. Therefore, he kept an instructor and trained himself. Then, determined to overcome by any means. It is because he wanted to enjoy water sports. He wanted to enjoy swimming, boating, fishing, etc. And therefore, he had made up his mind that he will surely learn swimming, even though he had unbearable past experience. Question number three. Why did mother warn Douglas against River Yakima? It was treacherous, which cannot be believed. Okay, it is deceptive. It had claimed several lives. This river, Yakima River, had claimed several lives, but proved opposite. Why opposite? Because it is not River Yakima which was about to take away life from William Douglas. It was safe pool of YMCA, okay, which was constructed according to the safety of the swimmer. Their misadventure happened and not in Yakima. So, here we find opposite things happening to William Douglas. Okay, number four. What made YMCA pool safe? Because it was built with the learners, keeping learners in mind. It was only 2-3 feet deep and 9 feet on the other hand. There were instructors and other learners which made it safe. Number five, what impact did the incident of California Beach have on little Douglas? He was choked by the gushing water where he had gone with his father, okay? And the waves swept over him. He was suffocated. This incident happened in presence of his father. And this was first incident which remained in his mind forever. Next question number six. Describe the big bully who plunged Douglas into the pool. See, that boy who was burly, surly, he was very proud of his impressive physique. He was so inconsiderate and irresponsible that he did not think that he might be taking away life of an innocent. And he did it out of sheer fun. He wanted to mock at the weak build of William Douglas. This shows bullying, ragging, okay? And this happens when proper bringing up is not done by parents. Question number seven. Describe the method adopted by the instructor to give a sense of security to the terror-stricken Douglas in the pool. At first, he attached a rope to the belt that was worn by William Douglas. Then, he arranged it so that it went through a pulley, okay, and it ran over his head, okay, through the cable he attached that rope and he held the other end of the rope in his hand, giving the security that if anything will go wrong, then he is going to take him up from the water. He made Douglas go back and forth without fear because this rope was there in his hand. He taught him breathing techniques and different swimming styles. So, piece by piece, he made William Douglas a great swimmer? Question number 8. What made Douglas decide that the instructor's role in teaching him swimming was over? Because they were into intensive training. For 6 months, they continuously trained. He continuously trained William Douglas and taught him all the techniques of swimming. Okay, so while swimming, number one, then breathing, then how to make his body light, etc. Right? Then integrated whole. Piece by piece he taught, and at last he integrated it into a whole, and then he said, go ahead. Okay, he said, go ahead to William Douglas, which confirmed that he was ready now. But, next question, let us see what happens. What does William mean when he says, the instructor was finished, but I was not? This shows, even after 6 months of intensive training, Douglas was apprehensive about swimming all alone in the pool. In the presence of instructor, it was fine, but he could not go into the water alone because whenever he went closer, his two incidences appeared in his mind and he became phobiatic. Okay, he practiced 3 more months all alone. Okay, all alone he practiced 3 more months. He went to Lake Wentworth. He went to westward of this lake, and then he was satisfied that he is able to swim all alone in the toughest water as well. Let's move ahead. Qualities of the narrator. Narrator was adamant. Okay, unless and until he gets what he wants, he is not going to move from the place. Okay, so this kind of attitude was of narrator. Then he was determined. He was undeterred. Nothing could stop him. Single-minded. He was single-minded to learn swimming. Relentless efforts, continuous, persistent efforts, okay, and optimistic that someday he is going to learn this art. He was confident about that and he was positive by his mindset. So, these are the qualities of the narrator. Then let us look qualities of the instructor. He was professionally very competent because he knew what to do with the narrator. He was conscientious. He was tremendously caring, meticulous and methodical in planning. Okay, let us see the very important question for long question answers. All we have to fear is fear itself. Explain. See, students, this is a quote from the play Julius Caesar, and it talks about cowards die many times while the brave taste death but once. So this is the essence of our lesson as well. Human beings are never going to get rid of fear. Therefore, they should learn to deal with this. Alright? It is built into their design principles. This is natural that we have different kinds of fear. Being human is having fear by human being is natural. Okay? But the areas of this fear, intimidation are different. If we cannot get rid of fear, then we should learn to manage it. Relentless efforts and undeterred single-mindedness can get rid of our fear. So these are the points you all are going to include. Instead of this quote, you can use your own as well, but it should be related to fear and bravery. Okay, so at last we find narrator was the hero of his own life. Okay, so all the best students for your examination.